14-year-old Jason Swift's body was found here at Ongar in November last year. He'd been sexually assaulted, drugged and strangled. He was known to have been involved in homosexual activity, and police now believe that was probably the motive. But despite all appeals for help, not one member of the gay community has come forward. So tomorrow, the man leading the hunt will set up a confidential answer phone for gay people to ring. It will coincide with visits to gay pubs.
It may be that for their own personal reasons, they do not wish to contact the police, but I can only say that this inquiry, which deals with the murder of two boys, is so important that I'd ask them to overcome those reservations.
Police hope new clues to the inquiry, which is now being linked to the murder of 6-year-old Barry Lewis from South London, will come from this computer. Called Holmes and put on show today for the first time, it's the most advanced ever used by London's police to try to track a murderer. It's also the first time a computer has been jointly used by two police forces. A computer centre like this is also in operation at Chelmsford as part of Essex Police's investigations into the two murders.
Up to now, we've used this system, which is a very comprehensive system where all the information is recorded on cards. The great difficulty of it is that any fresh information has to be manually searched throughout this index. With the computer system, all information is recorded and is immediately retrievable. And in addition to that, this computer is compatible to any other similar system. And therefore, any information we have here can be searched against information recorded at another murder office.
With Holmes and the new gay hotline, police are hoping they'll find the new clues they need to trap the two boys' killer. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.